Good morning all. I'm sharing this presentation on behalf of Dr. Suhas Bani, who is on travel in Vietnam. The research program on Asia comprises of complementing themes, which are crop improvement, integrated crop management, policy and impact, ICRI Settlement Center, and farm and engineering. Asia program now is a multidisciplinary team with synergy and treading forward with a well-defined strategy of working together and consortium, and also involving farmers in participatory research along with on-station strategic research to get demand-driven and holistic solutions. Now, looking at activities of different themes, the ICRI Settlement Center is involved in undertaking large-scale uptake of science-backed technologies. It is a glaring fact of the day that in spite of many game-changing technologies available, the plight of smallholders and dry-land agriculture is very poor. Actually, what happens in a life cycle of a technology, after passing through discovery phase, it reaches only pilot or proof of concept stage, reaching in around 100 or thousands of farmers, and does not cross what we call as a death valley of impact. For an impact to happen, the technology must reach in 100,000s or millions of farmers, and that cannot happen without active involvement of knowledge generating institutions along with knowledge disseminating institutions. That is why and where IDC is entering into strategic partnerships and taking proven technologies to large number of people. And during the process, we are also capturing lessons on large scale adoption, harnessing on synergies of partnerships. IDC is also involved in on-farm research in different agroecologies and backed with on-station strategic research for better understanding and solutions for real-time issues. Our studies show that there are large yield gaps on farmer fields by around 2 to 4 folds. Increasing land degradation, water scarcity, low yielding varieties are major challenges for realizing potential yields, and projected climate change is further compounding the problem and is a big threat for our food security. In our studies in India, we have found increasing land degradation due to extensive nutrient mining of secondary and micronutrients along with macronutrients, and decreasing carbon levels, which are jeopardizing our system level productivity as such. Taking leads from this increasing land degradation, Bhuchetna was one of the exemplar project where this soil health mapping and soil need-based fertility management was taken as an entry point activity. Block level fertilizer recommendations along with addition of micronutrients were scaled out in more than 7 million hectares, benefiting 5 million families. Farmers in Bhuchetna got benefits varying from 20 to 70% with benefit cost ratios of 3 to 15. And agriculture sector in the state as such recorded a growth rate of 5%, which was stagnant during last decade. And the accrued benefits were somewhere around 350 million in 5 year span due to increased productivity. Building on the benefits of Bhuchetna, government of Karnataka has also given one project, which is Bhuchetna Samriddhi. And it is targeted at enhancing system level productivity through integrated crop, water, soil, and livestock related interventions. Due to various interventions, the farmers have realized benefits of 100 to 500 US dollars per year per family. Government of Andhra Pradesh has also given one ambitious research project, which is Raithu Kosam, to achieve double digit growth in primary sector as such. In Raithu Kosam, we have adopted a two-pronged strategy of scaling out low hanging technologies on large number of farmers' fields in collaboration with line departments, and also we are working on developing pilots as field laboratories to test innovative technologies to sustain growth in future. In spite of very poor weather during 2015, the primary sector as such has recorded a growth rate of 8.5% in 2015. We are also working in watersheds in different agroecologies, and we have results have shown that management at watershed catchment scale is one of the proven technologies for natural resource management and improving livelihoods. We are also working on other issues like climate change impact assessment and adaptation, and wastewater recycling and reuse in agriculture. With regard to theme on integrated crop management, the major thrust areas are post plant resistance, pest virulence spectrum, mechanism of host and pathogen pest interaction, biological control, climate change and emerging disease and pests. The theme is well equipped with facilities for phenotypic facilities, climate change facilities and field and greenhouse screening facilities and other facilities required. As regards current project portfolios and outputs, I have indicated some of the major ongoing projects. And in case of pigeon pea, the major focus is on identifying genotypes resistant to phytopthora blight and also identification of morphological and biochemical traits in pigeon pea for attraction of Helicobarba. In case of chickpea, the focus is on collar rot for development of rapid diagnostic tool for identifying and quantifying the causal organism and also on mechanism of zinc solubilizing actinobacteria. In case of sorghum, the focus is on identification of influencing metabolites for development of stem borer and also identifying molecular markers associated with expression of resistance to the causal organism. The focus is also on characterization of cellulose degrading microbes in sweet sorghum. In case of pearl millet, the focus is on blast resistant. With regard to climate change studies, the studies are focused on understanding the changes in abundance and geographic distribution of insect pests and diseases and interaction between pests, host plant and environment. And also the focus is on identifying vulnerable regions and finding out adaptation and mitigation strategies. The theme on crop improvement is addressing issues in grain legume and dryland cereals. And with regard to grain legumes, the current project portfolios and outputs in case of chickpea are targeted at development of varieties suitable for mechanical harvesting and identifying molecular markers linked to QTLs associated with heat tolerance, drought tolerance in chickpea, drought and fusarium wilt resistant cultivars, and also QTLs for dry root rot resistance and higher yield in chickpea as such. In case of pigeon pea, the focus is on development of hybrids having high yields and also super early and medium duration varieties with resistance for disease, wilt, mosaic, sterility mosaic and phytopthora. The focus is also on developing seed production technology for hybrids. In case of groundnut, the focus is on identification of high oleic varieties and also high yield, short duration, drought tolerance and disease resistance. Pulse efficiency in Asia is a goal for which this theme is striving for. For an example, in case of India, the pulse production is short of around 4 billion tons. And ensuring pulse efficiency not only addresses food security issue, but also leads to resilience building of production system. And therefore, the theme is looking at identification and promotion of farmer preferred varieties in different legumes, in different states in India and other countries like Myanmar. The theme is also working on developing sound production and seed production system for ensuring availability of quality seed well in time and also sharing breeding material with different partners. As regard dryland crop improvement in dryland cereals, the current project portfolios and outputs in case of sorghum are targeted at higher yield and adaptation to post-rainy season, also increasing iron and zinc content and resistance to shoot fly, stem borer and grain mold, and drought and salinity tolerance, and also sweet sorghum for forage and biofuel. The outputs in case of pearl millet are focused on high yield and disease resistance, particularly blast and downy mildew, and also adaptation to drought and high heat stress, higher zinc and iron content, and development of forage cultivars. The theme on policy and impact is designed with a purpose to help in understanding ICRISAT's contribution towards different outcomes. It provides a credible evidence of impact, and it also helps us understanding what worked and what did not work and why. And as of now, the theme is undertaking baselines of Raithukosam project and watersheds in Andhra Pradesh. It is also undertaking impact evaluation study of Bhuchetna program in Karnataka, and also undertaking farmer producer organization scoping study in Andhra Pradesh, and also developing strategy papers for different countries in Asia and different states in India as such. The theme on farm and engineering service is a critical theme, and it is having diverse functions varying from farm development, operation and maintenance of 1,390 hectare area, providing controlled environment research facilities and other operation and maintenance of utilities like water, power and others. Now coming to the issue of collaboration with genetic gains program, the broad themes are basically molecular breeding of target crops and integrated crop management, microbial genomics, phenotypic and evaluation in different ecoregions. As of now, the current linkages are going on among different teams, but there is scope to strengthen it and also bring in mainstream breeding programs. But for this actually to happen, there need to be well-defined terms of references for regional programs and global programs, and that will really strengthen the collaboration. Thank you.
Thank you.